Hi, my name is Ravni Kundapavalur, and I'm a second-year neurosurgery resident at UCSF.
My name is Clara Starkweather. I'm a fifth-year neurosurgery resident at UCSF.
I'm John Andrews. I'm a seventh-year neurosurgery resident at UCSF.
Hi, good morning. Today we're at the UCSF Parnassus Medical Center campus, and today I'm going to show you what a day in the life of the neurosurgery resident is like. Follow me. Morning. It's about 4 a.m. I'm doing my morning rounds on the pre-op and post-op patients, and this is going to be the first one we're going to check in on. So this is what we call gravity rounds. We go from the top of the hospital to the bottom to go round on everyone. Hola, ¿cómo estás de mañana? So right now I'm running on about 15 patients out of a service of 80. This is approximately a fifth. We're structured into five different services across all the neurosurgery patients in the hospital. How many fingers?
Two, one.
Okay, let's try one more time.
Two.
Okay, big smile. I was a med student at UCSF before becoming a neurosurgery resident here, so I got to know the department really well. This is the place that has historically had the pioneers of neurosurgery, the best technical training, busy ORs, world-class researchers, and a proximity to Silicon Valley that provides for some really special collaboration opportunities. And now that we've rounded on everyone, we're gonna go and take care of the notes where we kind of put in the plans and touch base with the attendings on the plans for the day. There's a trace left facial droop, but neuro exam is intact. The drain has put out 100 cc's. We'll switch it out to a JP bulb today. Labs with a normal, the post-op MRI is pending. Okay for a 1 week taper for the decadrone?
Yeah, I think that's reasonable.
Okay. This is actually pretty unusual. A lot of programs have stricter hierarchies where the junior staff with senior residents, followed by the chief, followed by the attending. But at UCSF, second year residents communicate directly with the attendings for the plans. Okay, it's 6:30 a.m. and now we're headed to imaging conference where we go through the images for the folks who are new consults, admissions, and transfer center requests over the last 24 hours. She is alert oriented times 3, no cranial nerve deficits, has a mild word finding difficulties, naming 4 out of 5, counting and repetition are intact.
Any nicardipine or anything?
Had a little bit overnight, but has been weaned off.
So I'm a seventh year resident. Our seventh year is our chief resident, and that's our final year of residency. A core part of our job is being responsible and available for the juniors and making sure that any questions that they have about patient care, that they have somebody to answer those questions who's always available. When we're on call, the junior is the person who's in the hospital fielding the consults and the pages, and then they come to us when things get complicated or if they're not sure about something, or of course, if anybody does or might need surgery. Once we've gone through all those people, then we go down to the ORs, we consent patients, and then after that, I get breakfast, clear my head, and take a little relaxation time for a few minutes, and then go to the OR. Today I'm doing a craniotomy for a temporal lobe tumor, so let's go.
This is my lab space where I spend all of my days as a fifth-year neurosurgery resident. That's a little bit unique compared to other programs that do the research year sooner. During intern year, you learn basic operative skills like closing wounds and critical care management. During your second and third years, you're thrust into the full onslaught of consults and admissions and handling the pager in addition to basic operative skills. But then during your fourth year, you get to be a chief at local county hospitals like the VA and San Francisco General Hospital. To have that kind of crystallization of these basic skills that you've built prior to doing your research here, I think is invaluable.
We also have rotations at two different specialized children's hospitals at Mission Bay and Children's Hospital Oakland, Benioff Children's Hospitals. These are the rotations that I learned to love pediatric neurosurgery, finding out all the amazing things that we can do for these kids who just got dealt a bad hand in life. The Children's Hospital Oakland is a level one trauma center, so we see a lot of pediatric trauma. At the Mission Bay campus, we have a lot of the other specialized surgical centers, our epilepsy center and our vascular neurosurgery center. Between those two hospitals, you do get a very broad pediatric experience, which I think helps you really come out of this well prepared to pursue all the neurosurgical specialties within pediatric neurosurgery. This is the best part.
One of the defining features of this neurosurgery residency is the accelerated milestones. The clinical training here, the surgical training, the early exposure to the OR is on a completely different level than anywhere else that I saw in the country.
All right, done with the first case of the day, on to the next one. The more you do, the better you get. We do a lot of surgeries here, and we do a lot of the most complex surgeries here.
Look, the number one most important thing when you're choosing a neurosurgery residency program, at least for me, was becoming an excellent surgeon. And I felt like the training at UCSF would provide the closest thing to a guarantee of that.
There's a reason why UCSF is known for putting out the best neurosurgeons. This is a rigorous training program. It's hard, but it's meant to be hard.
Okay, so now we're in the OR where I will be assisting Dr. Berger with the meningioma resection today. I think one of the wonderful things about being here is that you get to work with true experts, both clinical and research experts in the field of neurosurgery. So Dr. Berger, of course, absolute legend in brain tumors. You also get to work with experts in spine, functional, peripheral nerve. We have the wonderful Dr. Jox, who also is a unique addition to our program to be able to learn those techniques as well. So kind of across the board, this is a place where you get to sample things. I'm a two. I get to work with Dr. Berger. So no matter what you're interested in at UCSF, there is an expert in that field of neurosurgery for you.
For me, that is functional neurosurgery. And there's folks like Dr. Eddie Chang, Dr. Doris Wong, Dr. Phil Starr, who are excellent surgeons at the very top of their field surgically and also have very impressive NIH-funded research going on.
These are all my equations. I'm just kidding.
I'm physically at UC Berkeley right now in the lab of Dr. Bob Knight. He's one of the foremost experts in studying the human prefrontal cortex.
Primary auditory should start about 12 milliseconds.
Yeah.
And it's sustained all the way through 200. That's great.
I'm studying the real-time computations that happen in the brain, in the orbitofrontal cortex, as people mitigate decisions. The way that I'm doing this is through a video game that I've designed to test something called approach avoidance conflict. So the video game was something that I built during my second and third year of residency. And this was only possible because I got a small departmental grant of $15,000 that I used to ask developers to properly build the game for me. I've benefited tremendously from the mentorship of Dr. Eddie Chang as well during my research here, and I've conducted recordings in many of his epilepsy patients and brain stimulation patients. And certainly this experiment wouldn't be possible at all without the kinds of clinical volume and surgeries that are happening at UCSF. So I couldn't have asked for a better research ecosystem. I'm analyzing data right now. I'm plotting out a figure, actually, that shows me what the neural activity looks like aligned to the exact time that a subject made a particular decision. In addition to that, I also had an entire internal committee help me put together an application for the R25 grant from the NIH for this year. And so that grant from the NIH is funding this entire postdoctoral year. Looking forward into my career, having a track record of getting funding to assure future employers, universities, that I'll be bringing in research dollars is very practical and very, very important.
There's a lot of elements that come into applying for jobs, but no one ever worries about whether a UCSF-trained resident can operate. We have a long history of putting out excellent neurosurgeons, and there's a long legacy to prove that.
Hi, I'm Dr. Eddie Chang. I'm the chair of the Department of Neurosurgery at UCSF. Our goal is to train the next generation of academic neurosurgeons. Not only do we want people to be outstanding technical, clinical neurosurgeons, but we also want to have people that are leading the frontier of research and future therapies. Graduates from our program have populated the very top academic medical centers throughout the country, from the Northeast to the West Coast and everywhere in between.
If I could describe my residency experience, it would be like drinking from a fire hose. You know, basically, UCSF residency is about a high volume of complex cases, high volume of research, high volume of clinical experience with many consults across multiple hospitals. So I think that's the best thing that you can have in training.
Outside of UCSF, of course, I am biased because I train at UCSF. But remember, after that, I work at Johns Hopkins, and then I work at the Mayo Clinic today. And what do my colleagues think of UCSF? Simply put, people at Hopkins, people at the Mayo Clinic, they know and they think of UCSF as being the top tier program to train as a resident.
For any sort of neurosurgical training program, you want that solid core of being in the operating room and doing a lot of cases. You want to be a safe surgeon, a very effective surgeon. But there's another layer on top of that that you have to cultivate to be an academic neurosurgeon, which is learning how to do research that's meaningful, that's impactful, and that's high quality and held to a very high standard of rigor. And that is something that you can only really get by seeing how people do it on a daily basis and live that sort of ethos. And that's something that a place like UCSF has in spades.
Residency is like an apprenticeship. You spend time every day working really closely with faculty. These are folks that are at the very top of the field. We call them top guns in neurosurgery because they really have achieved the highest level of academic neurosurgery in the fields of tumor surgery, vascular, spine, functional. You're going to learn the ins and outs, the tricks of our trade. This is what prepares our residents to be really some of the best that come out of the program onto the job market. They're highly coveted from other programs looking to build academic programs themselves. We've really strived to make sure the residents have all the resources they need to succeed.
We've got very strong mentors. There's a stipend for research. There's a department illustrator, a department statistician. There's even a stipend for reproductive health.
This could be anything ranging from fertility treatments. Some people spend it on a night doula, so if you have a baby during residency, you can sleep through the night, and some folks freeze their eggs. I've personally benefited from that, and it's very unique. It's something that I've long been jealous of my friends in tech having, but haven't had myself.
Of course, one of the concerns when you're living in a city like San Francisco is cost of living, but with the housing stipend and the adjustments for cost of living, we are some of the best compensated residents in the country, and frankly, everybody makes it work.
For me, San Francisco has just been a delight. And the access to nature is just abundant here, and it's something that I really, really treasure about living here. I often go cycling on the weekends with a group of friends that I've made. That's really invaluable for your mental health during residency.
I remember when I was applying to residency and people would say the line, oh, you know, it doesn't matter what city you're in when you're training, you're gonna be so busy, you know, you're never gonna see it anyway. And I think that's actually totally false. In fact, I think it's even more important to like where you're in when you have very limited time outside of the hospital. And I love training in San Francisco because you walk outside and, I mean, it's all this.
Parnassus is right next to Golden Gate Park, so it's about a 2-minute jog away. And we have limited time as a neurosurgery resident, and being able to run in December, March, at any given point in time, and the weather is absolutely beautiful, it's great.
So me and my co-residents are incredibly tight, and I absolutely cannot imagine being on this journey without them.
Our program is notorious for being a tough program. It definitely has its highs and lows, but honestly, the residents as a cohort were super tight-knit.
They're the people who kept me company in the trenches. They're the people who will pick you up every time you fall down, which there'll be many of those during residency. So being very mindful of how you fit into the culture and being part of a culture that fosters camaraderie is incredibly important.
Thursdays, we have academic days. None of the residents are operating, or if they do, they'll be done early on in the day. And that leaves the entire Thursday afternoon for not only doing research, but honestly to hang out. And it's great that that's built into our program to have fun, relax, enjoy the time off, and then go back to doing the hard work.
In terms of what it takes to succeed in our program, we're really looking for folks that, of course, want to work hard. That's a really critical part of the training. But I think some other things that are really important are also about a willingness to learn and honesty, humility. These are things that we look for in our very best residents.
Why I chose neurosurgery, it's an interesting combination of hand, heart, and hard work. You get to work with your hands to be able to do the surgeries, as well as try and kind of design therapies to be able to help patients out. Heart, I think that's the true crux of it. Patients themselves have various pathologies that affect their ways of living. It affects their movement, affects their way of speaking, interacting with other people, and it's great to be able to help them out and try and see, you know, how can we better that for them. And then finally, hard work. I mean, you saw us all come in 4 a.m. to round on our patients and then kind of prep all the notes and speak with attendings. And then now we're going to the ORs and then we'll go check in on the patients afterwards as well. And I think at the end of it, all of us in this field are so, so interested in trying to make the patients' lives better. And we're all driven by that common purpose. And that keeps me going daily to be able to put in those hours and see that work pay off in patients' lives.
And that's a day in the life of a UCSF neurosurgery resident. Thanks for coming along.
If you want to reach out to us, all of the residents would love to talk with you about what it means to do residency at UCSF.